talk about your heroes. That's a really remarkable story. In unfamiliar times like these, nothing quite like a familiar face.
I go to make a pickup from Yo-Yo Mendez. He says it ain't my corner anymore. It's Junior's.
Christopher, this ain't the time.
They're moving in. I say we go to DEFCON 4.
I gotta assess this, all right?
What are we, politicians? Does this look like the Senate to you, T? Hey, hey. This is about respect of our thing.
From one of the best shows of all time, we say hello to Michael Imperioli. Christopher, of course, from The Sopranos. Nice to see you, Michael. Good morning to you. You know, they did this with The West Wing. They called it The West Wing Weekly. And one of the things that Joshua Molina, one of the stars of the show, told me about being involved in the podcast is sometimes the fans knew more about the show than he did. Do you think you might discover that too?
I am actually discovering that, but largely it's because I haven't revisited or rewatched these shows since they initially aired. So that's going back a ways, you know, 20 years since we did, I think the pilot, 21 years. So I've forgotten a lot of stuff. So, and I'm watching them one by one. So when I refer to stuff like that's season two or three, right now we're in season one, I don't really remember it. So the plot, you know, elements. I mean, I remember behind the scenes stories and stuff that was going on in my life and some of the other actors and crew members' lives and stuff. But there's some like storyline things that I kind of forget here and there.
I tell you what, though, looking at that scene that we just showed, no matter the age, it completely holds up. As you've rewatched these shows that you haven't looked at for 20 years, are you finding that the case?
Oh yeah, they really hold up, and they're very timeless in a way. I mean, one of the reasons why we've decided to do a podcast was that in the last like year and a half, 2 years, a whole other generation of viewers have really latched onto the show. I'm talking about kids, you know, in their late teens and 20s and early 30s who were too young to watch the show when it was initially on HBO and who are now becoming obsessed with it. There's a whole other generation. So that's a real testament to how good the show is, I think.
And then I don't know if you felt this way at the time, but I don't know. Did you guys realize sort of the caliber and quality of stuff that you were doing?
You know, first we shot the pilot in 1997, and you couldn't really tell so much from the pilot, from the script. It was interesting. It was funny, but you didn't really get the whole scope of what it could be. And then in season one, when we came back the next year after we got picked up, we started shooting season one. Script after script got better, more complex, more interesting. Canvas got wider. And then we were like, okay, we're onto something really good. But whether or not people were going to watch, that was another story, because there hadn't really been hit dramatic series on cable. So that was an unknown, if that was going to work, if that was going to find an audience. And then it went on the air in 99, and it did.
Yeah, absolutely did. And, you know, people would tell you this, associated with Breaking Bad or other sort of premium cable shows, you guys absolutely opened the door. No question about that. The podcast is Talking the Sopranos with you, Steve Sciarippa. Really, really interesting. Is it super granular? I mean, are you like, oh, in that scene, that vase?
Very much so. It's both. Some episodes we have a guest. We've had Jamie Lynn Sigler, who played Meadow, Robert Eiler, who played Anthony Jr. We've had Michael Rispoli, who played Jackie Aprile. We have casting people coming on this week. So we have guests, but then we also we'll talk about other things, other aspects of our lives, our careers. But then when we do get into the episode, it's scene by scene. We pick it apart. We relate it to memories that we have from shooting it or things that were happening with us around the same time. So it is very granular. That's a good way to put it.
Very good. Michael, what a pleasure. Thanks so much. We'll tell folks that Talking Sopranos is available on Apple, Spotify, YouTube, and other podcast platforms. I tell you what, I have not tuned in yet, but Jessica and Frank, I'm going to. I mean, that show, even just looking at that one scene, you know,
it completely
The Sopranos
holds
always
up, as you
has
said.
Been...
Yeah.
Yeah. No, it's always been at another level.
I was just going to say, one of my sons, who was too young to watch it when it first started, is now in the process of watching the whole series. So I've been enjoying it again. So
yeah.
It's really fantastic. Yeah.